Hi, I'm Luis Serrano, and this is a story about my life. In particular, it's a story about how two things I never thought could be connected are connected. So let me tell you a bit about myself. All my life, I've suffered with OCD or obsessive compulsive disorder. And this can manifest itself in many ways. In my case, some things were very difficult, like stepping on sidewalk lines or other things I had to do in pairs or in sequences. Sometimes I'd be blinking my eyes or moving my neck in funny ways and people were wondering what was happening. In reality, I was just running a sequence inside my head and I couldn't get away from it. So anyway, later in life, I became a mathematician. And my research and my PhD thesis were on combinatorics, which is the study of sequences and patterns. And I didn't make the connection at the time, but maybe deep down in my subconscious, I was so obsessed with sequences that I needed to conquer them instead of letting them conquer me. But anyway, today I will tell you a story regarding that. It's a story about a particular sequence that I was obsessed with as a child and how that sequence later helped me solve a math problem in a math competition, and the problem was about certain sums of powers. So here it is. So this is me as a kid walking on the sidewalk. And throughout all my life, including now, I cannot for the life of me walk over the sidewalk lines. If I accidentally step on one, then I have to cancel out that step with a series of other steps that would actually go on forever, or at least until I arrive to my destination, and then I would have to stop. And the sequence is the following. Let's say I stepped on a line with my right foot. Then the universe is unbalanced, and I need to balance it. And how? Well, by stepping on the line with my left foot. And we're done, right? Well, I wish. After this, I had to continue on a strange sequence in order to balance the universe. Let me explain that sequence a little bit better. So basically what happens is that I needed to balance everything. And if I have a right step, then the way to balance that is with a left step, right? But except that now I've done a right step and a left step. And the only way to balance that is by doing the complete opposite, which is left-right. And are we balanced now? Well, not really, because I just did right, left, left, right, and I need to balance that. And the only way to balance it is by doing the opposite, which is left, right, right, left. And you can see how this goes on forever, right? Then I did this, and I need to balance it by doing the opposite, and that sequence would just go on forever and ever, and it will never be balanced. Another way I saw this is with cars. Let's say we have a red car, and that's a right step, and the only way to balance that is with a blue car, which represents a left step. However, this is not balanced, because if this was a race, then red was first and blue was second, and that's not balanced. So the only way to balance that is by running another race where now blue wins and red is second. And now is the world balanced? Well, not really, because if this was the same first race, then the blue cars were third and fourth. So red occupied the first and fourth spots and blue was second and third. So red still won because they got the first one. So the only way to balance this race is to run another one where blue occupies the first and fourth spots and red occupies the second and third. However, if this was a whole race since the beginning, then red still wins because they have the top spot. And that goes on forever, so I would always have to run a race that has the complete opposite positions. But then the races would join and red still win, so I would never be able to balance this sequence. So in short, the sequence that I was building was the following. We have an R, and then we copy that sequence except do the complete opposite, which is an L, and then we append it at the end, and then what we have, we flip it completely, so the RL flips into LR, and then gets attached to the end, and then that sequence gets completely flipped, and then attached at the end, and then that gets flipped, and gets attached at the end, and so on and so forth. So the sequence that I was walking was this particular sequence that goes on forever. So let's fast forward some years later, and I was in high school taking a math competition, and I found the following problem. The problem says, find a way to split the numbers 1 to 32 in two groups in such a way that the following conditions hold. Each group has the same number of elements, so each group will have 16 elements. The sums of the numbers in both groups are the same. Also, the sums of the squares of the numbers in both groups are the same. The sum of the cubes of the numbers in both groups are the same. And the sum of the fourth powers of the numbers in both groups are the same. So this looks quite hard because there's many ways to split the numbers 1 to 32 in two groups. But that's a lot of conditions to be satisfied. I mean, here's a way to split them, but that obviously doesn't satisfy them. Here's another way. Here's another way. And the actual solution, I'll spoil it, is this one. These two groups have the same sum of squares, sum of cubes, and sum of fourth powers. But let me show you how I got to the solution. So my first thought was the following. 32 is too big, and it's also a power of 2. So let's try with smaller powers of 2 and see how we do. So let's try with 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 numbers, and we want to split them in a way that the sum is the same, and maybe the sum of squares, maybe sum of skews. So it's a very balanced way to split them. So let's try the most balanced thing I can think of, which is this. And that works out in some way because 1 plus 4 is equal to 2 plus 3. They're both 5. Now, what happens if we try the sums of squares? Well, if we try the sums of squares, we have that they're not the same. They're 17 and 13. So we only got that far with 4 numbers. But let's try with 8 numbers and see if we can get more of these sums of powers to be the same. So how do we split the numbers from 1 to 8 in the most balanced possible way? Well, I tried a few. I tried this one. I tried this one. I tried this one until finally something worked, because now we have sums are the same. They're both 18. And the sums of squares are the same. They're both 102. I tried the sums of cubes and they didn't work. But we're getting somewhere. But let's go back. We have the numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4, and we really want to split them in a balanced way, which is this one. However, balanced way reminded me of something. What if I color the ones in the left blue and the ones in the right red, and then I put them back? Then I have blue, red, red, blue, which reminds me of right, left, left, right. There's that sequence again. So what happens if I keep going? Remember what we did before? We flipped right, left, left, right to get left, right, right, left. And that gives us the colors of the next 4 numbers. We have 5, 6, 7, and 8. So the red numbers are 2, 3, 5, 8, and the blue numbers are 1, 4, 6, 7. And that was the second set I got, where 1, 4, 6, 7 have the same sum as 2, 3, 5, 8. And then the sums of squares is also the same. So maybe if I keep going on this sequence, nice things will happen. Let's see. If we continue it for the next 8 numbers, that gives me the colors for the numbers 9 all the way to 16. And if I split them into 2 sets according to the color, then the sums are going to be the same. They're 68. The sums of squares are going to be the same because they're 748. And the sums of cubes are the same. They're 9,248. So I know what to do for 32 numbers. All I have to do is the same thing. I draw my sequence all the way to 32. That gives me the colors for the numbers 1 to 32. Then I split them into 2 sets according to color, and that works beautifully. Let's check. The sums are the same. They're 254. Sums of squares are the same. They're 5,720. Sums of cubes are the same. They are 139,392. And the sums of the fourth powers are also the same. They are 3,623,048. So that's the solution to the problem. For 32 numbers, all I have to do is do my sequence, cut them into 2, and then I have the same number of elements, the same sums of squares, the same sums of cubes, and the same sums of fourth powers. And you can see that this generalizes. For 2 to the n numbers, all I have to do is draw my sequence all the way to 2 to the n, and that gives me the colors of the numbers 1 up to 2 to the n. Notice that 2 to the n is colored purple there, because in some cases it's going to be red, in some cases it's going to be blue, depending on the parity of n. But if I split the sets into red and blue, then I have 2 sets with the same number of elements, the same sums of squares, the same sums of cubes, and all the way to the same sums of n minus 1 powers. So that was the solution to the problem, and that's how that sequence came to my rescue. Many years later in life, I actually found out that that sequence has a name. It already existed. It's called the Thue-Morse sequence, and it has many, many very interesting properties. I encourage you to look it up on Wikipedia and check. It's a really cool sequence. But yeah, in particular, the one we had here is that if I take it all the way to 2, I have the same sum of 0th powers, which is the same number of elements, because the 0th power of something is 1. If I go all the way to 4, I have the same sum of numbers. If I go all the way to 8, I have the sum of squares. All the way to 16, I have the same sum of cubes. All the way to 32, I have sum of fourth powers, etc., etc. So naturally, the next question is, how do we prove this? It's a beautiful result, but it needs a proof. So I've worked out a proof that I think is really nice. It uses generating series. Generating series is a way to encode sequences algebraically to actually manipulate easier. But this will be done in a subsequent video. However, I would love it if you work it out yourself. And if you have a proof or an argument, feel free to put it in the comments or send it to me. I would love to take a look at it. So thank you very much. If you like this, please subscribe, like, share, and comment. As I said, if you have any interesting ideas for the proof, I would love to see your comments. You can also put them on Twitter. My Twitter handle is LuisLikesMath. So I will see you very soon in the proof video for this. Bye-bye.